Cinda,
Oh, so funny. My dogs just got all excited. They're like, "Who's here?" Like,
doing? Somebody's
"It's
hit.
my
No.
dad."
So a little birdie told me that you're going to be in LA tomorrow and you're going to be recording with some legend players, some cool cats, and what's going on? Tell me what's happening.
Well, so someone nominated me to do a song with an organization called Cancer Can Rock. Their tagline is "Because music lives forever." Oop, don't cry, Cinder. And they feel like you should have a perk for having cancer. And that's all they do. They raise money so that a musician with cancer can make a record. And you can go to cancercanrock.org. So anyway, so I'm doing a song with them. It's a song I wrote a couple of months ago called "Unbreakable Heart."
Oh, that's good.
Kind of how I feel about what's going on with me. And if you know me, that's what it looks like. And then there'll be great session or famous musicians. I don't know exactly, but my producer, Jim Ebert, he said, "I hate to break your heart, but you know, I'm gonna have somebody else play guitar." I'm like, "Dude, that's fine." And then Kara from The Voice, I don't watch TV, but she's gonna be singing also, singing backgrounds. So that's
Wow.
but you know, Steve, I wondered, you know, sometimes I'm a little shy about my voice. I've always loved to sing. I've always felt I've had a beautiful voice. And then as I've been writing for Sync, I do get told periodically that I'm dated. So if you could just, the thing about working with you, whenever I work with you, when I make a suggestion, you are like, "That's great." Like I got a lot of confidence being around you. So I wondered if you had any tips for me and about tips for being in the studio and about getting my best performance.
Gosh, yeah, great questions. Well, first of all, I've heard your voice a bunch of times on what you call demos, and people can say everyone has an opinion. So it's like some people would say, okay, that's dated, but okay, so if somebody says that it's dated, so what does that mean? Does that mean that you can't make money off it or you can't get placements? No, that's not true. And so it's so cool because I encourage everybody to be yourself, be your unique self, and whatever you love doing, do that and find a way to get placements with it. That's your job, not trying to be like yes. You can make your voice a little bit more modern just by like a little tip that I do is I'll listen to Justin Bieber, or I'll listen to some of the latest, the top 10 singles or the top 10 on the Billboard charts, and I will listen to their melodies and I'll find out what they are, if it's da 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 whatever it is, and I'll go over that 1,000 times. I'll change the key, da 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 da, and I'll go over that until it becomes sinks in, like, because our brains and our memories like a sponge, till it sinks in. Then that could becomes a part of my next song. I end up accidentally putting it into the song. So we're talking about the melody of a song being, kind of changing it. But it's the same with your texture of your voice. Back in the what was it, back in the 60s, 70s, there's a lot of vibrato. So there's a lot of vibrato on the songs. So if you want to be if you'd want to be more modern, simple little technique is just hold back on the vibrato a little bit more. And there's one other thing too. One thing I noticed, Ariel Grande. Okay, so she's obviously modern and current. She is singing so breathy. She's singing really breathy all the time. So I don't know if you heard what I just did there. I'm like singing, and so we can do that. You can start practicing breathing. So having that mindset of, and I just want to encourage you that don't take that if someone says it needs to sound more modern or it doesn't sound modern. Put that in a little box and put it on the in a little box and put it on the shelf and be like, all right, well, I'll work on that when I want to work on it. But that does not mean you can't get placements. It does not mean that you can't be successful. It does not mean any of those things. So I want to keep encouraging you that you totally can do that. And I know you also asked another question. Sorry, I'm getting carried away. Asked the other question of any techniques. Probably. Just try not to get in your head when you're and hopefully if they're a good producer, they're not saying, sing it better. Is that all you got? Can you sing it better than that? And I'm sure they wouldn't. But I have had that a few times, and it's very hard to get out of your head and just be like, you just want to. It's just like, well, yeah, you want to sing it better, you sing it better, I'm done. So, but yeah. So I'm coming back to any techniques or anything. The biggest one I probably suggest, yeah, just have fun. Try not to be in your head and practice the song before. Like, go through your being in your head, practice the song a bunch of times before, and then go in the studio, just have fun. It is what it is. When you're in the studio, you're not there to practice. You know, you're just like, let's sing it again. All right, let's sing it again. All right, you want me to do that little part? I'm good. We'll do it again. And, but that's not the time where you really, let me sing it a little bit, and you're trying to fine tune everything. Try and do that before you get to the studio and just rely on the muscle memory. But that's kind of about the biggest tip. But keep it fun. Keep it fun. Oh, one more thing I'll tell you. We all know a famous singer. If it's a softer song, and I think you've already told me the song is more upbeat and a little bit more upbeat. So this wouldn't work. But I know if you're singing a ballad or a slow song, light 100 candles in the studio. Let it be so like just ambient and just sing it. But this is not in that case. So maybe have a few.
Yeah, some fireworks.
Have a few drinks. Coffee drinks to keep you up high. So, but
Okay.
I'm excited
All
for you.
right.
I'm really excited.
Thank you. And I just want to say what really landed for me right there. I heard everything, but when you were saying, oh yeah, you want me to do that? I'll do that again. Oh yeah, I'll do that again. I'll do that again. And like that is the essence also of who you are. Like you just roll and you roll and you roll and you just do it and you got that smile on your face. So that is what I'm gonna take with me, Steve. Thank you so much. I'll let you know how it goes.
Yeah, you should do a video so we can see all the
Oh
do
yeah,
it.
they're gonna be videoing, they're gonna interview me and they're gonna video the recording session and everything.
That's so cool. That's cool.
Now I have to go figure out my outfits.
Do you know what studio it is, or can you say what studio it is, or do
I don't know. I don't know.
you... Yeah. You'll have to let us
But
know, because you could be in a Village Studios or some famous one where there's all sorts of people. You could be. Who knows?
I mean, it totally could be. There's a lot of known people who
Yeah.
back this organization.
That is really, really cool.
It's really cool. It's a perk to having cancer.
There you go. I love the attitude. Well, awesome. Yeah. You got any last thoughts or anything before I let you go?
No, although I'll be gone for a few days, and I just can't wait to get back and see what's happening here when I get back as well.
Awesome. Awesome. Go, Cinder. Woo!
Thanks, Steve. Bye.
Yeah.